So today class I am explaining about the bolted connections. So in the previous class I discussed briefly, and especially today class I will explain what is the bolted connections, what are the different types, what is the terminology, the most important one, terminology, and the problems and the conditions, as well as the code, what code is saying as per the IS 800 2007. So which page numbers are most important, page numbers of IS 800 2007. So I will take morning class as well as the afternoon class also. In this class I will explain completely regarding the theory as well as the equations, and then tomorrow class we will solve some problems. Okay, so now I will draw one thing, please understand carefully. So if you take a plate here, these are the bolts. Okay, the distance between the center to center bolt we denoted with the P. This P we call it as a pitch, pitch of the bolts. So what we call it as a pitch of the bolt is nothing but it is a center to center spacing of the bolts in one row along the direction side. So this one we call it as a P, and second one is G, which we denoted with the P, and next one is a gauge distance G. This is from here to here. This one we denoted with the G, that is the distance between the two bolts in adjacent side. Okay, in adjacent rows, and we measured it as a right angle to the direction of the load. This space, this distance, we call it as a G, that is the gauge distance. And one more important thing, the edge distance. Edge distance E is nothing but from the center of the bolt to the edge of the plate, we denoted with the E. And edge distance E dash is there. That E dash is there, that means from the edge to the nearest bolt, we call it as a E dash. And one more important thing, when the two bolts are like this, these two bolts distance, we call it as a staggered distance. Staggered distance. Okay, this center to center distance of staggered bolts, we call it as a staggered distance. I will show you the important thing. Now this is the completely terminology of your bolts. This one I am showing here, please look into this one. I will show you the bolt. This is the bolt, and here whatever you are observing, there is a rows are like this. This one we call it as a thread. Okay, now we have to know this bolt diameter. At the same time the bolt nut is there, we have to take the bolt hole also. How we will take this hole as per the bolt diameter? There is a condition as per IS 800 2007 code book. I will show you the table which is having in the 73 page of IS 800. So like this, we have to take the bolt and bolt diameter. Now we have to design the bolt and bolt diameter, and how we will take this all those things. I will show you the page number IS 456. Please wait for 1 second. Yes, if you observe section 10, the connection chapter is there. So in this, there is a clearance of fastener holes. That means the nominal size of fastener, that means for suppose the diameter of the bolt, whatever you are observing here, this diameter of the bolt, based on this diameter of the bolt, how we will take the bolt hole. That means if the diameter is 12 to 14, the size of the hole is nominal diameter of the fastener plus clearance, that is 1 mm. We are taking here the standard clearance in the diameter and width slot is 1 mm. If it is 16 to 22 mm, the size of the hole is this one, the nominal diameter of the plus clearance. For suppose I will write here, 1 second. Yes, what it is saying, for suppose diameter of the fastener is around 12 mm. Okay, now if you want to know the hole of the bolt, that means 12 plus 1 mm. That is dia plus 1 mm. So how much? 13 mm is the hole size. Like that, you have to calculate. This one, how the standard clearance is they given? 1 mm, 2 mm, 3 mm, like that. Okay, same like that, we have to calculate the size of the hole. Okay, this is the clear understanding level. You see, if the diameter is 24, you have to add 2 mm. That means, for suppose 24 plus 2, 26 is the hole diameter. Okay, this is the most important thing. And one more important thing is, see, if you observe in the page number 75, so all the equations are there for the solving of your problems. In this today class, I will explain each equation and which one, how we will calculate the problems from these two equations. All the equations are available in the page number 75. Please remember, my dear students, page number 75 itself is showing the bolted connections problems equation. Okay, now what I will explain, as per the IS 800-2007, how the standard clearance hole I explained till now, same like that, what is the minimum spacing between the two holes, maximum spacing, and all those things they written here, you know, like from 2.5 times the nominal diameter, like that, all the conditions are there in the from the 10.1 clause number you will observe in the 73-74 pages. Anyway, now I will explain each and every clause clearly for your better understanding. Okay. Yeah, today class I will explain each clause number. Okay. Then we will move to the problems. Okay. The first clause, what it is saying. One second. Yeah. The first clause, it is saying the pitch. I told you what is the pitch, means the distance between the two holes. It's not less than 2.5 times the D. D is nothing but the diameter of the bolt, dia of bolt. This is the first condition we have to know. And the second condition is pitch shall not be greater than 16 T or 200 mm. Okay, whichever is less. For suppose if I am taking a member like this, one plate, and here one plate. Okay. And here, these are the bolted connections. Three bolts are there here. Okay. The load is applying on this like this. So what happens? This distance, the plate distance, we denoted with the thickness of the member or thickness of the thinnest member. Okay. So here what it is saying, the pitch, the distance between these two is either it is 16 T or 200 mm. Whichever is less, we have to take that one. And next condition is, this one is for the tension member. That means we are applying a tension. Now the same thing, if I take a member like this, these are all things already they given in the page number 73, 74, 75 of IS 800, but I am explaining clearly for your better understanding. For the compression member, if you take, the pitch is nothing but we have to take 12 T or 200 mm. Whichever is less, we have to take this one. Okay. And the stagger case, I told you already that those are the staggers are there. The bolts. These are the bolts. These two we call it as a staggered bolts. So at that time, how the distance will be, how the pitch is there, we have to increase the 50% of the values, whatever we specify above. Okay. And one more important thing, in this bolted connections, we have two types of the bolted connections. The first one is lap joint, the second one is butt joint. Okay, the lap joint is, we know already, it is the simplest way. I will draw here for your understanding. When the two plates are connected, overlap one another, we call it as a lap joint. Okay. For suppose if it is a one plate and one another plate, these both are joint like this. Okay. Then I will take the bolt and I will insert here like this. okay, insert like this. This type of we call it as a lap joint, okay. And I am applying a load here, P, tensile force. Same, this is a single line bolting, okay. That's why you see only we are applying only single line bolt. The same thing if apply for the two line bolting. Applying a load P. This is a single line. This is the double line bolting. Okay, and also how it look like means, you know, if I draw a cross section for this case from here and up to here like this, there is a bolt. Then you will mention like this. But suppose there is a double line means. So all of you understand clearly from here. See, this one is a bolt. Here you have to draw. This one is a bolt. Excuse me. So this is the concept behind the lap joint single line and double line concept. You see, here only two plates are one each another. These two are overlap each other. There is a single bolt here, and here if you observe the two bolts are there. That's why we denoted like this. We denoted like. Now, whenever you are solving the problem, you must know this one, whether your bolted connection is, whether it is single or double, or whether it is a lap or butt joint, okay. And same time, there is a one more condition is there. Please wait for 1 second. This is the chain connection. We call it as a chain connection, chain bolted. And also zigzag bolted also is there. This one is like this. We call it as a zigzag bolted. Zigzag bolted. These are all covers under the lap joint. And one more important thing, coming to the butt joint, we have two types of there in the butt joint also. The first one is a single cover butt joint. And the second one is a double cover butt joint. In this, what they are saying, the two main plates a butt against each other, and the connection is made by providing a single cover plate or double cover plate. Like this, for suppose, if it is a member or steel plate, and one more member is there. Why? Because I will show you here. This member is this member. These are not overlapping like this. Okay, these two joints are there. Now I will provide one more plate here. That means a single cover. I will provide the cover like this. Okay, then I will fix with the bolts. The two bolts. This one we call it as a single cover bolts. The section is like this. You see? Here like this, these two are the bolts. This one also bolts, okay. And same like that, we have to draw for the double cover joints. This one and also this one. So the joint maybe covers are on both sides, either on the top or the bottom. Then we will fix the bolts, two bolts. This is the double cover joint. Okay, these are the two types in the butt joint. But anyway, in case of butt joint, when you are taking the butt joint, the pitch must be restricted to 4.5 dia for a distance of 1.5 times the width. That's why we will take this one. And the gauge length G, it should not be more than 100 plus 40 or 200 mm, whichever is less. So my dear students, these all conditions are available in the page number 73. All of you refer that one and you will understand very clearly. No problem. And also I explained what is the edge distance. Edge distance I shown you here. Yes. Yeah, this one is the edge distance from the center of the bolt to the edge of the plate. This distance we call it as a edge distance. So what is this conditions? What is the IS code 800-2007 code is saying for the edge distances? Anyway, I will write now. Yeah, the minimum edge distance, it shall not less than 1.7 hole diameter in case of sheared or flame edge condition. And one more condition, it should not less than 1.5 hole diameter in case of rolled connections, rolled or flame or sun, whatever it may be. This is the edge condition. What is the minimum edge condition? Means it should not be less than 1.7 times the hole diameter for the normal edge conditions or normal cuts. And one more condition is it should not be less than 1.5 times the hole diameter of the rolled connection. This is the minimum edge condition. And what about the maximum edge condition? I will write here. Maximum edge condition is, if you write here the maximum edge condition, it shall not exceed 16th epsilon, where epsilon is square root of 250 by Fy. So, and T is nothing but thickness, I told you already, thickness of thinner outer plate. Okay. And this is the condition A. The condition B is 40 plus 40, where thickness of the connected plate, the T is thickness of the connected plate, whatever we will take. So this is the minimum edge condition and also maximum edge condition. So apart from the required bolt from the consideration of design courses, whatever we are applying, either it is a tension member or compression member, there will be a taking fasteners should be provided some cases, those are sometimes these plates should be exposed to the weather, or these plates to exposed to the not exposed to the weather. At that time, we will take, there is a condition 32 R 300 or 16 T R 200 mm, whichever is less. If it is not exposed to weather, these are the two conditions we taken, and most of the cases, all those things, whatever we discussed still now, here I will show you in the IS 800-2007 clearly. So my dear students, all of you go through this one, page number 73 onwards. The chapter is connections, and my dear students, in the examination, if you know the page numbers, the writing of solution for the any type of problem is very easy if you get the bolted connection. You see the standard clearance table number 19, that means here I told you already. Okay, and next, standard clearance, oversized hole and short and long slab, minimum spacing two times the, I done this one, and maximum spacing, you see 32 or 300 mm. Whatever code book is saying, the same thing I am writing still now, I explained still now. Okay. And distance between the center to adjacent pitch, it shall not exceed 16 T or 200 mm. And whichever is less for the tension member. For the compression member, 12 T or 200. So these are the clauses, whatever I am explaining still now, each clause number saying clearly in the page number 74. So my dear students, you must know the page number 73 and 74, all the clauses are explained, what is the minimum spacing and maximum spacing, as well as the tacking fasteners and also other things, they explain very clearly. Okay, now I will explain, so before entering into this equation, I will explain one concept that is very, very important thing. Yeah. So how the shear plane and also a bearing occurred in the structure. there is a concept shear and bearing, and also we will call it, we will shear capacity and bearing capacity also we will do it in the next. I will explain the equations in the next class, afternoon class. In that, by using only that equation, all are available in the code book only. Directly we will take that equation, we will enter the values, then you will, your problem is finished. Very very easy problems. Okay, so now if I take a member like this, okay, this is a bolt, I am applying a load. What happens if it should be like this? This is a thread. So here, from here, load is applying here, and also load is applying here, from here. So again here, P, and again here, P. So this is the shear plane will happen like this. That means I will run again. So this portion we call it as a shear plane. Okay, and what is the bearing plane means? It is like this. The shape is like this. That means before breaking the bolt, it will go to like this. This portion we call it as a bearing plane. So my dear students, this is the most important thing. You must know how the shear will happen and also how the bearing will occur in this both conditions. If you observe here, it is a bolt, whatever we take, there is a tension member. If you observe here, the tension load is applied. So then in a single cover, how it is showing, so I'm explaining clearly. Okay, that's why it is the most important thing. Everyone must understand this one clearly. Okay, same like that, this is the shear plane and also this is the bearing plane. Before breaking the bolt, we call it as a bearing plane. It will go like this. Okay, same like this, if I taken in the what is, we call it as a two plane subjected to shear. If it is a butt joint, double cover butt joint I am taking now. So this one and this one, these are the bolts. Okay, what happens? First one is applying the tension forces. Top and both are applied in the same condition, in the same axis. The P here, P and also P again. Yeah, why? Because first we will take this portion, and second this portion, and third this portion. So like this, we have to take, and we will write the shear plane, how the shear will happen. Okay, this is the condition where we subjected to the shear and also bolts. Okay, and one important thing is I will explain clearly the grade of the bolts. The grades of the bolts is available in the textbook as per the IS codebook 1367 part 3 or ISO 898. So the specifications of the fasteners, the grade or classification of the bolts, it is from this, from 3.6, 4.6, 4.8, 5.6, 5.8, 6.8, 9.8, 10.9, 12.9. These are the grades are available for the bolts. From these bolts, each one having yield stress as well as the ultimate stress and also elongation. But suppose if I take 3.6 bolts, the yield stress is 180 MPa and ultimate stress is 330. So like this, we have each part as per the IS 1367. We have different types of the grades are there of the bolts. From this only we will take. please wait for 1 second. And my dear students, so still now whatever we discussed, these are the things before going to the equation part. From this one, we have two types, bearing bolts, and we have to know the shear capacity of the bolt as well as the bearing capacity of the bolt. We have two equations are there. Those are shear capacity and also bearing capacity. Those two are very, very important. So once if I explain those conditions, the next class onwards, that means afternoon class, I will explain those equations. So next I will explain directly, we will enter into the problems only. There is no theory at all. Okay. The bearing capacity, how we will calculate of the bolts, and also shear capacity. We have for these two, each one having some equations for the calculation of bearing capacity and the shear capacity. So in this problem, directly they will give the bearing, the bolt diameter and also the plate grade and all those things they will give. Based on that only we will calculate the bearing capacity as well as the shear capacity. In the afternoon class, I will explain what is bearing capacity and what is shear capacity and what are the problems while solving the problem, how many equations we will use under the bearing capacity, under the shear capacity. And my sincere request, all these equations are available in the IS 800 code book. So here if you observe in the IS 800 code book, please look into this one. See, in the page number 75. So all of you go through page number 75. All the equations are there. Anyway, elaborately I will explain in the afternoon class. Okay. And before that, there is one more topic I will explain. How the failure design strength of the plates in a joint, there will be some failure will occur. How the failure will occur, I will explain and I will end by today class, morning class. This is the last theory concept. Afternoon directly I will explain the equations. Then next class onwards, problems. So the first one is bursting. The second one is crushing. The third one is rupture of plates. So due to this only, there will be a failure. For suppose if I take a plate, I am applying a load. Okay, the bursting means it happens like this. The crushing means if it is a plate, the crushing happens like this when you apply a compressive load. And also there is a rupture. How the rupture will happen? This is the bolt. For suppose it will go like this. Okay, this is the rupture. So like this, we have a lot of the things are there. Before going to design strength of the bearing bolts, so we have to calculate the, I told you, shear capacity. So for the problems, only this concept is important. Remaining all whatever we discussed, only theory. So from now onwards, whatever I explain in the afternoon class regarding shear capacity and also bearing capacity, we have two types of equations are there. Only those two equations we will use in the problems while solving the bolted connections. Okay. Anyway, this complete terminology I explained still now regarding the bolted connections and all those things. And I will stop my share.